I love Bear. I've loved it for almost a decade. I use other apps here and there, but I've always come back to Bear. It's got a perfect mixture of features versus usability. It just strikes a really nice balance. And frankly, I think it's really pretty. Who doesn't want to use a nice looking app? In Johnny.Decimal world, the concept of a central index, which we call your JDex, is critical to the whole system. People think that their file system is their index, but it isn't. It can't be. There are so many things that aren't files and so many places that your files can be. So you need one central place, a canonical reference for all of your stuff. I compare a system of organization without an index to a library without a catalog. It's not a library anymore. It's just a building full of books now. So this is how I keep my personal JDex in Bear. I want to achieve two things with this series. First, to show you all the ways that you can use your JDex to stay organized. It's much more than just a bunch of static notes. And second, to show you all of Bear's features. And I mean all of them. I'm really going to try and cover everything because I want you to know what this thing can do. And it's one of the nice things about Bear. It's not obvious on the surface because it's simple how complex it can be and how clever it can be and what it can do for you. I'm aiming this series at the sort of person who might be new to this note-taking JDex idea, but who wants to get organized. So you might be considering using Apple Notes for this because it's available and it's free. And many of these techniques I'm going to show you will translate to Apple Notes, but I honestly really just don't like it. I've tried, I really have. And so I hope I can convince you to give Bear a go. So this is my actual Bear setup. I haven't created some classroom scenario here, and so it's worth pointing out that a few things might not be the default settings. Mostly, I think just this middle pane preview style, which I shrink to small. By default, it's large, and you'll see later why large isn't so useful for me. If you're brand new to Bear, you'll have four welcome notes, which are worth reading. A note here, I am a Bear Pro subscriber. This is one of those apps that you can get and use for free, but really to use its proper features, you need to be a Pro subscriber. It's something like $20 a year, not even that. So it's really reasonable. I know everything is a subscription these days, and I know some alternatives are free, like Apple Notes, but you get what you pay for. It's really good value for money, and some of the features I'm going to show you are Pro-only features. So get the free trial. There's like a two-week trial or something. Get the trial, have a go. It's the best money I spend. One downside of Bear that I might as well note up front is that you can't share your system, as in you can't invite your partner to also be part of it, and you can't simultaneously edit notes together. You can export your notes, you can send them out wherever you want, as I'll explain, but you can't share it. There's just no way to do that. So if you do need to share your system, you just can't. It's also Apple platform only. One of the nice things, though, as a result of the way they've built this system, is that it synchronizes with the one Pro subscription. It synchronizes everywhere instantly. So one subscription gets you iPad, iOS, and Mac, and everything syncs instantly and quickly, and it's really great. We're going to use scenarios from my life in this series. So in each of these, I'm going to show you a specific example. And the one for today is 13.15, selling my stuff, which I'm using to sell an LP, as in a vinyl record. All these examples are going to be from our life admin pack. So the first feature of Bear is quick open. It lets you jump to any note near instantly. And it's the first feature in a theme that I'm going to introduce, which is that it's generally quicker to use the keyboard than the mouse, and that you should aim to use the keyboard as much as you possibly can. Almost everything's got a keyboard shortcut, so if you can learn them, you're going to just be much more efficient. This one is Command-O, or there is a menu item here. I'm not going to keep showing you these menu items because they are really easy to discover. In the help menu, you can type something here, and if it is a menu item, your Mac will tell you where it is. And I mean tell you with like a little wiggly indicator. It's really neat. Works in any app. This isn't a Bear thing. This is just a Mac thing. And then alongside the command, it always lists the keyboard shortcut if there is a default one. So let's open 1315 selling my stuff using command O and typing 1315 selling my stuff. Now, I know the number and the name of this one because I've been preparing this course, and so it's in my memory, but I'll show you later what to do if you don't know the number or the exact title of a thing. Even if you think you know Markdown, even if you do know Markdown, watch this bit. But just a note, if you really, really do know Markdown, you can skip using the chapter markers at the bottom of the video. So everything you write in Bear is in this language called Markdown. It's a really simple language for formatting text. It's really popular, and basically every app uses it, every Notes app. But if you're coming from something like Apple Notes, which doesn't use it, it might be unfamiliar. It's actually one of the reasons I don't like Apple Notes, because it forces me to use weird, like to do a subheader in Apple Notes is Command-Shift-J. What does that mean? It doesn't make any sense. In Markdown, that's two hash symbols, which you will see shortly. In a nutshell, you can represent all of the usual stuff that you'd use to format a document. Headers, bold, italic, lists, links, just using plain text characters. So for example, let's add a new header so that we can store information about this record that we're selling underneath it. And in Markdown, as I've just mentioned there, you get a header by typing a hash symbol and a space. And one hash symbol is the first, the biggest level header. Two hash symbols is the next level header, and so on. Now that's it. That will work in any app. That's Markdown, right? That will work in any app that supports Markdown. You didn't even have to learn a keyboard shortcut. You didn't have to learn Command-Shift-H or something. It's just a hash symbol. You'll see that I've started this header with a date, which we'll get back to later. That's a Johnny Decimal thing. Let's just type myself some quick notes to create a bullet in Markdown, a bullet list. Start the line with a dash and then a space. I put this record in a safe place. That's why I thought to use this one. This was just the other day. I actually put it in a safe place, which meant that I didn't know where it was anymore. Fortunately, Lucy did. So I'm going to remind myself where that is. And I've taken some photos, so I'm going to remind myself where they are. So this is the kind of the point of the JDex. The point of your JDex is to serve as your central record, because there are all these places a thing can be, including physically the records in the top of the wardrobe. And so your JDex serves as your central point of where all your things are, whether they are physical, files, emails, notes, whatever. Just to help demonstrate Markdown, we're going to add some unnecessary formatting. So I'm going to make this italics by putting it between underscores, and I'm going to make this bold by putting it between two asterisks. If you want bold and italics, you just combine those things. And note that you can use either asterisks or underscores for both bold and italic. What makes something italic is one of those things. What makes something bold is two of those things. So you could just do three asterisks, and that is bold italic. I find that weird and confusing, so I've just chosen personally to use underscores for italic and asterisks for bold. I do that everywhere in my life. You do whatever you want to do. Note that when your cursor steps outside this editing area, the underscores and what have you disappear. There is a setting for that if you want to keep them visible, which I sometimes do. You can uncheck this setting. Okay, so what? Why is this interesting? Well, the beautiful thing about Markdown is that it's totally portable. You can copy-paste this anywhere. There's nothing special about it. It's just text with asterisks around it. But Bear and other Markdown apps see that, and they know what it means. And they can choose to do special things with it. Like in Bear, you can fold a header. And we're going to see this properly later. You can copy-paste Markdown anywhere. It's how I write everything, including my website. Here's the Markdown, and here's the website. It's as simple as that. So we've gone from Apple Notes or Word or whatever, which just kind of makes a thing bold in this way that can be really hard to troubleshoot sometimes. I think we've all seen a situation where Word is just making a thing into some sort of bulleted list, and you don't know why and you wish it would stop. It's kind of invisible magic. We've gone from that to Markdown, where it's really clear, because if something's bold, it's because it's between two asterisks. That's why. That's the only reason that something is bold. It's really simple. And when you copy this text elsewhere, all you're really copying is two asterisks and some words and two more asterisks. There's no special code behind it. It's just what you see. This makes all of your writing portable across applications and across systems. This works across Mac and Windows and Linux and the web. Because watch what happens if I copy-paste this header and some bold text out of Notes and then paste it into this plain text window. This is text editor on a Mac. All that information, all that concept of a thing being a header or bold has gone. But look what happens when I do the same from Bear. The formatting comes along for the ride. And even if the app you're using doesn't support Markdown, which text edit doesn't, it doesn't matter because it was designed to be human readable. I think it's amazing that Bear is 100% Markdown. It's not the only app. Many, many apps are 100% Markdown. But the fact that it is means that there is no lock-in to Bear. You can always just export your notes as Markdown and move them anywhere else. in that way, I kind of feel that Apple Notes, which is notably bad at being an import-export app. You essentially can't import and export things into Apple Notes and retain formatting. It's a mess. And I feel that Notes is really kind of stingy in this regard. It feels cheap, you know? It feels like they're scared. If we let you import and export, you might try another app. Well, yeah, I think you should. I think you should try Bear. Okay, this is not a Markdown course. This is a Bear course. So here's how to learn more. Please learn this stuff. It will double your happiness. Bear came with 4 starter notes. And if you have deleted those and you want them back, you can get them back here. One of them shows you a bunch of this formatting. So you can have a click through that. And you've still got this format menu in your menu bar. All that does is to apply Markdown for you. So select some text, give it a format, see what it does. Bear also has a Markdown reference page on their site, and there's a link in the description below. And we'll use a bunch more Markdown through this series, which I'll call out when it is interesting. This whole 3-pane thing is pretty familiar. Left is some sort of organization, middle is your list of notes, right is the note itself. So I'll just focus on what makes Bear special. First, you can swipe either left or right to hide or reveal these panes. And this works on your Mac trackpad or your iPad's screen, where it's particularly delightful. You need to swipe in the note area, otherwise swiping a note title does something else, which we'll cover later. These menu options are here if you'd rather use the keyboard, and this makes for a really nice focused writing mode if you combine the only view, the note view, with full screen. That's really pleasant. One of Bear's major features is its system of tags, because there's no concept of a folder in Bear. Your notes are just in Bear. But these tags let you organize them however you want, and they work really nicely with Johnny.Decimal because we use them to mimic our system's structure. So this is the Life Admin pack, which is at area 10 through 19 Life Admin, category 13 Money Earned, and so on. And Bear's tags allow you to create a hierarchy like this just by using a forward slash in the tag. And you can use any character, including an emoji and a space, as long as you also close the tag with another hash. And that is fairly unique to Bear. I'll show you a lot more about tags later. Don't worry about that P76 personal thing at the front of my tag. That's just an extra level of organization to separate out my personal system from some old work systems. Just a note, because it's a feature I don't actually use, but it does exist. You can store anything in Bear, in a Bear note. You can store images, PDFs, a spreadsheet. You just drag it in and that's it. It's now in the note. Now, personally, because Johnny.Decimal gives me this neat folder structure that mirrors my notes with the numbers, I don't tend to use attachments, but I could see how they'd be really handy. Like if you're going to an exhibition and you want to drag the ticket in there, and now it's available on your phone and you don't have to scratch around in your email when you get to the venue. That's really nice, and I should probably use it more for this sort of thing. All right, let's keep each of these videos reasonably tight. That'll do for today. Next up, I'm going to show you how to search our notes. See you next time.